सो हे गाइज, वेलकम बैक वंस अगेन टू द सेशन ऑफ PIB 247। मैं हूँ मनीष मिश्रा एंड इन टुडे सेशन गाइज वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस सम मोर इम्पॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम द PIB न्यूज विच आर रेलिवेंट फॉर द ESI सेक्शन ऑफ RBI ग्रेड बी एंड NABARD। सो लेट्स बिगिन विद द सेशन गाइज, बट बिफोर वी बिगिन, इफ यू आर कमिंग हेयर फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम, डू सब्सक्राइब टू आवर चैनल एंड यू कैन प्रेस दिस बेल आइकन। यू कैन ऑल्सो जॉइन दिस टेलीग्राम ग्रुप फॉर डेली क्विजेस एंड अपडेटेड इन्फॉर्मेशन रिगार्डिंग द डेली सेशंस and other relevant information regarding the courses. So let's begin with the session guys, and let's talk about the very first question, which is about the mission for integrated horticulture development. So you have to consider the following statement regarding this mission for integrated horticulture development, and you have to identify the correct statement. All right, correct statement aapko identify karni hai out of these three, and these three statements are regarding this mission. Now the question is why we are discussing this mission, because recently the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, which is headed by Mr. Narendra Singh Tomar, has allocated rupees 2250 crores for the development of horticulture sector for the financial year 2020, which means this financial year. So for this financial year, for the horticulture sector, rupees 2250 crore has been allocated by the ministry, and this funding has been done under the mission for integrated development of horticulture. Ek mission hai for integrated development of horticulture, us mission ke andar this funding has been done. And remember, talking about this mission, so this mission guys is being implemented since 2014-15, which means it is still under implementation by the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare. Its objective is to realize the potential of the horticulture sector, covering fruits, vegetable and all other related crops. And its broad objectives also include to increase the area under the horticulture crops and also to enhance the productivity of the horticulture crops. Horticulture crops ke under ka jo area hai usko badhana, and also to increase the productivity of the horticulture crops is also the objective of this mission. And talking about some facts, so due to this mission, area and production during the years 2014-15 to 2019-20 has increased by 9% and 14% respectively, which means area under the horticultural crop has been increased by 9% from 2014-15 to 2019-20. While if you talk about the production, so it has been increased by 14%. All right, and it has also not only resulted in India's self-sufficiency in the horticultural sector, but also contributed towards the realization of sustainable development goals. Like for example, zero hunger wala jo sustainable development goal, it is helping in realizing that. It is also helping in realizing the SDG of ending the poverty. Alright, iske alawa, if you talk about the challenges in the mission, what are the challenges in the mission? So we all know that there is a very high post harvest loss in our country. Then there is a gap in the post harvest management. Harvest हो जाने के बाद जो crop का जो management है उसमें काफी ज्यादा gap है अभी भी. And there is also a very huge gap in the supply chain infrastructure in our country till now. अभी भी हमारे यहाँ पे जो supply chain infrastructure है, in case of horticulture crops there is a huge gap because we do not have the robust mechanism for the supply chain. जो हमारी supply chain है उसके लिए हमारे पास कोई बहुत अच्छा mechanism नहीं है. जैसे कि हमारे पास cold containers नहीं है, जो जिसमें फ्रिज वगैरह लगे होते हैं, इस तरीके के कंटेनर्स नहीं है जिसके थ्रू हम अपने हॉर्टिकल्चर क्रॉप्स को एक जगह से दूसरे जगह पे लेके जा सके. ऑलराइट, सो दीज आर सम ऑफ द चैलेंजेस एंड दैट्स इट अबाउट दिस न्यूज. एंड नाउ लेट्स कम बैक टू द क्वेश्चन. यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई द करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट. द मिशन इज अंडर इम्प्लीमेंटेशन सिंस 2012-13. नो, इट इज अंडर इम्प्लीमेंटेशन सिंस 2014-15. ऑलराइट, फॉर 2021-22 the fund allocated is rupees 5200 crores. No, it's 2250 crores, which means this statement is also incorrect. And the mission has resulted in increase in area under horticulture by 14%. No guys, this percentage is 9%, while the production has been increased by 14%, which means guys all the statements are incorrect, but you have to identify the correct statements. So therefore the correct answer should be option D, none is correct. All right, and now let's move ahead to question number 2. Which of the following state or UT has become the fourth state or UT to be declared as the Har Ghar Jal state or UT under the Jal Jeevan Mission? Maine aapko pichle session mein bhi bataya tha, we have discussed it, that Jal Jeevan Mission is the flagship program of the Ministry of the Government of India under the Ministry of Jal Shakti. Ministry of Jal Shakti ke andar ye kaam karta hai, and it has the objective to provide tap water connection by the year 2024 in every rural household. हर household में 2024 तक tap connection पहुंचाना is the basic objective of Jal Jeevan Mission, or you can say the Har Ghar Jal Mission. And recently, Puducherry has become the fourth state or UT to be declared as Har Ghar Jal under this Jal Jeevan Mission. And before this, Goa, Telangana and Andaman and Nicobar Islands have been declared as the Har Ghar Jal state or the UT. And if you remember, Goa was the first state to be declared as Har Ghar Jal state in our country. And talking about the UT specifically, so the first UT to be declared as Har Ghar Jal UT was Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Alright. Iske alawa, the state of Punjab and Union Territory of Dadra and Nagar Haveli and Daman and Diu have crossed the milestone of covering 75% of rural homes with the tap water connection. इन्होंने 75% का tap water connection का जो milestone है उसको cross कर लिया है, and also they will definitely achieve the target by the year 2024. Alright. Now, JJM, as I told you, is a flagship program of the Union Government to provide tap water connection to every rural households by the year 2024. Talking about its funding, so this year's budgetary allocation to this scheme was 50,011 crores was the budgetary allocation. While talking about the Finance Commission grant, so it's 26,940 crores. So around 1 lakh crores is there for the funding under this mission, which is known as Jal Jeevan Mission. Okay, and now let's come back to the question. So therefore, fourth state or UT is Puducherry. Option C will be the correct answer. Okay, and the first one was Goa. First state was Goa, while the first UT was Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Alright. Now let's move ahead to question number 3, which is about the India-European Union meeting, which was held recently. And from India side, Honorable Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi participated. So consider the following statements regarding recently held India-European Union meeting, and you have to identify the incorrect statement. So guys, let's talk about some of the key facts from this India-European Union meeting. So this meeting was the initiative of Portuguese presidency of the Council of European Union, and all the leaders from all the 27 European Union member states participated. Jitne bhi 27 member states hain European Union ke, sabhi ne participate kiya isme. And it was initiated by Portuguese presidency of the Council of European Union. Now there were three thematic areas of discussion. Number one was foreign policy and security, COVID-19, climate and environment, and number three, it was trade, connectivity and technology. Do remember these three, the three thematic areas of discussion during the India-European Union meeting. Number one was foreign policy and security, then COVID-19, climate and environment, and number three, it was trade, connectivity and technology. Alright. Now there were some launches also, there were some announcements also. Number one, there was an announcement to launch connectivity partnership, which will be focused on enhancing digital, energy, transport and people-to-people connectivity. So all-round connectivity will be provided by this partnership between India and European Union. And it will be based on the shared principles of social, economic, fiscal, climate and environment sustainability and respect for the international law and commitments. Basically, all the spheres will be covered during the implementation of this connectivity partnership, and it will enhance the connectivity ecosystem between the India and European Union member states. Alright. And this partnership will also catalyze private and public financing for connectivity projects. Iske alawa, there was an announcement that okay, free trade negotiations will be there. The members agreed to resume the negotiations for balanced free trade and investment agreements. And if you remember, India and European Union are in the process of negotiating a bilateral broad-based ट्रेड एंड इन्वेस्टमेंट एग्रीमेंट सिंस 2007 से ही इंडिया और यूरोपियन यूनियन आपस में एक फ्री ट्रेड एग्रीमेंट के बातचीत के दौर में है. बट नाउ दिस फ्री ट्रेड नेगोशिएशन के लिए द मेंबर्स हैव बीन एग्रीड. ऑलराइट. इसके अलावा इन द एरिया ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी देयर वर सम अनाउंसमेंट्स इन द क्लाइमेट चेंज ऑल्सो, बट दीज आर नॉट इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर द एग्जाम. क्लाइमेट चेंज में बेसिकली दे सेड ओके दैट वी विल फॉलो द थिंग्स दैट हैव बीन पॉइंटेड आउट बाई दी पैरिस क्लाइमेट अग्रीमेंट. जो पैरिस क्लाइमेट समिट में जो भी चीज़ें थी, हम उनको फॉलो करेंगे. सच थिंग्स हैव बीन सेड ड्यूरिंग दिस मीटिंग. टेक्नोलॉजी की बात करते हैं तो इंडिया एंड यूरोपियन यूनियन अग्रीड टू इन्हांस द बायलेटरल कोऑपरेशन ऑन डिजिटल एंड इमर्जिंग टेक्नोलॉजीज. जो डिजिटल और इमर्जिंग टेक्नोलॉजीज है उसमें बायलैटरल कोऑपरेशन को एनहांस किया जाएगा, सच एज 5G, AI, क्वांटम एंड हाई परफॉर्मेंस कंप्यूटिंग, और यू कैन से क्लाउड कंप्यूटिंग। एंड मेंबर्स ऑल्सो एग्रीड फॉर अर्ली ऑपरेशनलाइजेशन ऑफ द जॉइंट टास्क फोर्स ऑन AI एंड डिजिटल इन्वेस्टमेंट फोरम। आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस और डिजिटल इन्वेस्टमेंट फोरम के लिए एक जॉइंट टास्क फोर्स बनाई जाएगी, उसको जल्दी से जल्दी ऑपरेशनलाइज करने के लिए मेंबर्स हैव बीन अग्रीड। ऑलराइट, सो दीज आर सम की टेक अवेज फ्रॉम द इंडिया यूरोपियन यूनियन मीटिंग। इसके अलावा बहुत सारी बातें हैं गाइज विच आर नॉट रेलिवेंट फॉर आवर एग्जाम, दैट ज्यादा डिटेल में जाएंगे देन दैट विल बी फॉर UPSC एग्जाम। सो इतना ज्यादा डिटेल में जाना इज नॉट रिक्वायर्ड फॉर आवर एग्जाम। ओके, सो इनकरेक्ट स्टेटमेंट्स वी हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई। द डिस्कशन ड्यूरिंग द मीटिंग वॉज बेस्ड ऑन 3 थीमेटिक एरियाज, दिस इज एब्सोल्युटली करेक्ट। अ कनेक्टिविटी पार्टनरशिप हैज बीन लॉन्च टू एनहांस डिजिटल एनर्जी ट्रांसपोर्ट एंड पीपल टू पीपल कनेक्टिविटी, दिस इज ऑल्सो करेक्ट। And the France presidency of the Council of European Union had initiated the meeting. No, that was Portuguese. Okay, Portuguese presidency of the Council of European Union had initiated this meeting, which means third statement is incorrect. And therefore, the correct answer should be, guys, option D, only 3, because we have to identify the incorrect statement. All right. And now let's move ahead to question number 4. In fact, there is a report. In place of question number 4, we will discuss a report, which is Niti Aayog report on financial inclusion. So this report has been released by Niti Aayog in association with MasterCard. All right, I hope आपने MasterCard का नाम सुना होगा, MasterCard के जो हमारे credit card और debit card आते हैं। So Niti Aayog and MasterCard released a report which is titled as Connected Commerce, Creating a Roadmap for a Digitally Inclusive Bharat. So basically to promote digital financial inclusion, को promote करने के लिए क्या recommendations हो सकती हैं, this report tells us this. And this report identifies the challenges in accelerating the digital financial inclusion in India and also provides recommendation for its betterment. Okay, तो हमारे digital financial inclusion में क्या क्या challenges होंगे और उसकी क्या क्या, उसको खत्म करने के लिए क्या क्या recommendations होंगी, that have been provided by this report. Alright, now these are some issues that have been identified in the report. Number 1, digital financial inclusion for underserved sections of the Indian society. जो हमारे society का underserved section है उसको हम कैसे डिजिटल फाइनेंशियल इंक्लूजन के एम्बिट में लेके आ सकते हैं। देन इनेबलिंग SMEs टू गेट पेड, गेट कैपिटल एंड गेट डिजिटल एंड एक्सेस कस्टमर्स एंड इंश्योर देयर कंटिन्यूड रेजिलियंस। जो स्मॉल एंड मीडियम एंटरप्राइजेज है उनको कैसे पैसा मिले, उनको कैसे कैपिटल मिले और उनको कैसे डिजिटलाइज बनाया जाए, इसके ऊपर ये हमारा एक बहुत बड़ा इशू है इन द एरिया ऑफ फाइनेंशियल इंक्लूजन। पॉलिसी एंड टेक्नोलॉजी इंटरवेंशन टू फॉस्टर ट्रस्ट एंड इंक्रीज द साइबर रेजिलियंस, बिकॉज Guys, we all know in the ecosystem of digitalization, there is a threat of cyber security. So there is which is a huge issue in the case of financial inclusion. Digitization of India's agriculture sector is also one of the issue in the financial inclusion, and also the essential elements of a digital roadmap to make transit accessible for all citizens. Basically, जो हमारा जो financial inclusion है वो हर citizen के लिए accessible होना चाहिए. Only then it will be a success. Okay, so these are some issues that have been identified by the report. And talking about the recommendations, so ab hum recommendations ki baat kare. So number 1 recommendation is to strengthen the payment infrastructure to promote a level playing field for both NBFCs and banks. NBFCs aur banks ke liye ek level play field banana bahut zaruri hai taki hamara jo payment infrastructure hai usko strengthen kiya ja sake. Then digitizing the registration and compliance processes and diversifying credit sources to enable growth opportunities for MSMEs. Basically, paperwork को reduce करना पड़ेगा if we want to increase the ambit of financial inclusion. Building information sharing systems, including a fraud repository, that is basic necessity of this digital financial inclusion, and ensuring that online digital commerce platforms carry warnings to alert customers to the risk of fraud. Fraud से बचाना ही पड़ेगा, बिना fraud से बचाए हम फाइनेंशियल इंक्लूजन को डिजिटल नहीं बना सकते। देन इनेबलिंग एग्रीकल्चर NBFCs टू एक्सेस लो कॉस्ट कैपिटल, सो वी हैव टू प्रोवाइड लो कॉस्ट कैपिटल टू द फार्मर्स, ओनली देन द फार्मर्स कैन हैव द एक्सेस टू द प्रॉपर कैपिटल। एंड डिप्लॉय अ फिजिटल, सो दे इंट्रोड्यूस्ड अ न्यू वर्ड फिजिटल विच मीन्स फिजिकल प्लस डिजिटल मॉडल फॉर अचीविंग द बेटर लॉन्ग टर्म डिजिटल आउटकम्स। क्योंकि बेसिकली क्या है, इन द एग्रीकल्चरल सेक्टर हमें दोनों की जरूरत है, फिजिकल की भी जरूरत है और डिजिटल की भी जरूरत है। सो इनिशियली वी शुड स्टार्ट विद द हाइब्रिड मोड ऑफ फिजिटल विच मीन्स फिजिकल प्लस डिजिटल मॉडल। ओके, एंड टू मेक सिटी ट्रांजिट सीमलेसली एक्सेसिबल टू ऑल विद minimal crowding in queues, leveraging existing smartphones and contactless card, and aim for an inclusive, interoperable and fully open system. Basically, we had to develop a system which will be inclusive, which will be interoperable, which will be fully open to all. Okay, so these are some of the recommendations, and now the question is कि इसमें से किस तरीके का क्वेश्चन पूछा जाएगा, बिकॉज आई डोंट थिंक कि देर विल बी ऑब्जेक्टिव क्वेश्चन. आई डोंट थिंक दैट देर विल बी ऑब्जेक्टिव क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम दिस न्यूज. सो आई हैव मेड अ सब्जेक्टिव क्वेश्चन फॉर यू फॉर दिस न्यूज, एंड द क्वेश्चन इज इफेक्टिव फाइनेंशियल इंक्लूजन इज नीडेड फॉर अपलिफ्टमेंट ऑफ अंडर प्रिविलेज सेक्शंस ऑफ द सोसाइटी बाय प्रोवाइडिंग देम विद मॉडिफाइड फाइनेंशियल प्रोडक्ट्स एंड सर्विसेज. Examine the statement in the light of recently released report of Niti Aayog and MasterCard on digital financial inclusion. So that is the question and iska answer. If you talk about its answer, you have to write the answer. You have to write the answer. Now the question is, how will you submit your answer? So you have to join the Telegram group. Us Telegram group mein you can submit your answers, or you can also directly message the answers to me. In the Telegram group, you can easily find me. एंड देयर अब वहाँ पर जाके आप डायरेक्टली मैसेज कर सकते हो. आई विल चेक योर आंसर, आई विल गो थ्रू योर आंसर, एंड आई एक्सपेक्ट कि आप लोग गाइज इसका आंसर लिखोगे. और यू नो कि सब्जेक्टिव भी होता है ESI में, तो इस तरीके की न्यूज़ जहाँ पे ऑब्जेक्टिव क्वेश्चन पॉसिबल नहीं होगा, आई विल ब्रिंग टू यू द सब्जेक्टिव क्वेश्चन. राइट, सो यू हैव टू राइट द आंसर टू दिस क्वेश्चन एंड देन सबमिट इन द टेलीग्राम ग्रुप ऑफ anujjindal.in. राइट, एंड गाइज दैट्स इट फॉर द सेशन टुडे. आई होप ऑल द क्वेश्चंस आर क्लियर. And the next session will be on Friday. Milte hain agle session mein. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.